Hey guys, welcome back to Better Biomed. Today, I am gonna show you guys a problem that I never even knew could possibly happen, and we found it on accident. So what's really going on is it's been identified that the air and the oxygen are crossing somehow in this facility. And you know, we went through all the normal suspects and we found a panda warmer. It's the craziest thing. So let's go ahead and show you what to look for. So if you have any of these older units in your fleet, you'll know exactly what to key in on so that maybe you can solve this problem before it becomes a big problem. All right, let's do it. All right, guys, you can see I have the blender actually removed. It's been gutted. This is a 2008 year machine. And some of the symptoms are when it's at 21%, it was shooting an off number. All right, so you can find this during a PM, but here's the thing, is you have a switch right here that flicks on and off the blender. And if this is in an off position and your blender has air coming out, then you know something's wrong. It's actually the switch right here. The switch right here is the problem. So I'll show you how I can prove that. So what it's doing is, because there's bypass going on in the switch, it's contaminating your med air with oxygen. So you're not getting the correct percentages that you would normally be expecting. Your percentages are going to be much higher. And believe it or not, it's not the blender. So the blender does need to be still rebuilt every 2 years. But if you're sitting at 21%, you should be experiencing atmospheric close to 21%. We were getting 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 some percent on, depending on the unit that we checked, but all of them were drastically higher than what they should have been. So during a regular PM, you're shooting 21%, you will definitely see it. And it doesn't matter which one of these you try out. But we were testing it at 5 liters on this port. And the key indicator during the PM is that when it's in the off position, we had output, which was really odd. And then we checked the percentages. Percentages were off. So let's go ahead and take a look. The blender itself is currently getting rebuilt in this room as we speak. But in its absence, here's something that you should notice. First off, yes, these need to be trimmed back because they're discolored and they're pre-crimped. That can be a problem for leakage in the future. But these guys right here, which come up to your pneumatic switch, it's a dual gas feed switch. So you have oxygen and you have med air that are switched when you turn it on. But here's the thing, I have pressure as soon as I connect this to the wall when it's in the off position. So that means that the blender squawk, which you should hear when only one supply is connected. So let's say I only connect this to the wall without the yellow, the med air, it should squawk. You should hear this sound, you know, you guys know what I'm talking about. And just the opposite, you connect this one without this one, you should hear the same squawk. I wasn't getting that squawk. So what's going on? Well, it's because of this bleed by. It's because the switch has got probably some O-rings that are wore out and you've got bleed by happening. So it's contaminating your med air with oxygen. So we got a superficially high quantity of oxygen at our readings. And these guys here had pressure when the switch was off. How crazy is that? Anyway, guys, I just wanted to show that and maybe give you guys a little heads up on the Giraffe unit, or the Panda, stupid Panda unit. Never heard of that before, never experienced it, but good thing that the staff at this particular facility was very vigilant. As soon as they detected that the med air was contaminated, they called us in so we could do an in-depth investigation, and that's what we found. Thanks for watching, guys.